Right, welcome back to Brand X Reviews. We're just about to watch and then review Empire Strikes Back. I think it's pretty much safe to say that it's widely held that Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi are pretty much the two best films of the six.
So. And interestingly enough, also the two not directed by George Lucas.
There might even be a connection there, you think, possibly?
Just maybe.
Saying in the other reviews, it's the Blu-ray version of The Empire Strikes Back, which was released in 2011. First off, just in terms of differences, very minor on this one. It's probably the...
Yeah, even more minor than the CGI rocks. It was like a couple of CGI sparks at one point.
Yeah, there's nothing really else that they've added in. I think most of what they've changed over the years got changed in the 97 cinema special edition that was released on tape, which was... this box set, and then again they changed it in 2004 with the DVD release. It's pretty much as similar as what we have in this one anyway. So any other thoughts on Empire Strikes Back just to begin with?
Well, it's certainly the darkest of the trilogy, naturally. Probably one of the first films I can remember watching as a child that kind of ended in not exactly a victory for the heroes, kind of a defeat in a lot of ways.
Yeah, no,
which is
I mean, we're
kind
quite
of an interesting part of the trilogy for that.
Yeah, I mean, we're quite young. I mean, we were just kind of like grew up with these films, and they'd already been out for. It was 1980 when this was made.
So, I mean, in fact, this was before we were born.
Yeah, exactly. So, but you can imagine for people wanting to see it at the cinema, having to wait, you know, 3 years, pretty much ended it on a cliffhanger, and coming out of the cinema and thinking, bloody hell, I'm gonna have to wait 3 years to find out what happens next. It's kind of rare that happens in films, isn't it? I mean,
yeah, and it is a pretty big cliffhanger, really, when you think about it.
I mean, most of the time in films like that, it's usually, say, like, I know they did it with The Matrix 2, which is a shocking film, but I mean, it was only a 6 month wait until the next one came out.
Yeah, they were kind of made back to back. Films just weren't made that way back then.
Yeah, and like Back to the Future 2 as well, that was kind of a cliffhanger, but again, it was like a year, so to wait.
Anyway, yeah, you wanted to talk about the Christmas special and, of course, Boba Fett.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, this is something that, kind of jokingly, in the last review, kind of mentioned this Star Wars Christmas special, but I've never actually watched it before, but for those of you that don't know what it is, I'll just briefly say it was something that aired in, I think it was 1978. Well, I say Christmas special, it's more known as a holiday special. You could probably track a copy of this down. It's not commercially available to buy, but you can get bootleg copies. I think this is, I can't remember where I got this. I didn't even remember that I even had two.
And I'd just like to make one point. The man who supported Jar Jar Binks, who loves the prequels, George Lucas wants to forget this ever happened. Be afraid.
Yeah, he said at a convention in Australia one time that he wanted to get hold of every like copy of this and just destroy it, basically. So that's George Lucas saying that.
Yeah, exactly. That's the guy who thought Jar Jar was the funniest thing in Star Wars.
Phantom Menace passed on his watch, you know. So it's about an hour and a half long, but it aired on TV and it has most of the major actors from the original trilogy in it. And of course it has Princess Leia singing at one point. I'm not kidding. You track it down. Can you imagine
it exists. These aren't
the original, like the original prequel trilogy, like Samuel L. Jackson, like singing, like on camera. He was on the bridge of midnight.
Right.
Yeah, you wouldn't really got off the one of there, but yeah, you really.
Yeah, it's I've only seen bits, but I haven't actually seen it all the way through myself.
But there is a good bit in it with the cartoon segment, and it introduces, because this came out between Star Wars and Empire Strikes Back, so...
Which is why they're joking, we've got to watch this now.
Yeah, so it kind of fits between...
Trust me, this doesn't bridge the two in any way. You don't need to see this understand them.
But there's a cartoon segment where it introduces Boba Fett, and this was a character, obviously the bounty hunter, was quite well known. Presumably you will know who that is if you're watching this video at all. But they did introduce an action figure of Boba Fett in, I think it was the late 70s, was it 1979? It'll say on the back somewhere. Yeah, 1979. So this came out a year before the film actually introduced him. So they were kind of pushing his character before. Originally the figure had like a rocket that you could fire out of his backpack. But his... it was something that they kind of stopped because some like parents groups thought that like a firing missile might like, I don't know, shoot kids in the eyes or whatever, so they just kind of...
It's very stupid to think of now, because how many toys are that do stuff like that?
Yeah, it's fairly...
It's just like considered a standard thing nowadays.
Yeah. But you can get these like off eBay and stuff, and this is probably worth maybe £10-15, something like that. I think the last time I checked it was anyway, I don't know if the value probably tends to go up and down.
Anyway, back to the film.
Yeah.
The DVD features, you've watched some of the extra stuff that you were alluding to before with the Family Guy and stuff, so if you want to...
I mean, we've kind of, in each video, we've kind of commented on the extras that are on the... have you got the Blu-ray box set?
Yeah.
Just so we know what we're talking about. It's this Blu-ray box set. It's the extras that are on it more than the actual films and what they've done to the films that makes it worth getting. I mean, we did kind of say in the prequels, we were saying how the extras were a bit rubbish, but that's more as they pertain to the original, well, the prequel trilogy, but...
And like I said, just the stupid thing of having fairly important cutscenes, deleted scenes and so forth, which aren't actually included in this box set, but are included on the DVD, which is...
Yeah, that's, like we said, specific to the prequels, but when you get into the original trilogy, you know, Star Wars, Empire Strikes Back, Return of the Jedi, the extras do seem to pick up. There's some original documentaries that were made when the films originally came out, and there was one that came out in 1977 when the original Star Wars came out, and it's got interviews with the actors, and in fact, Carrie Fisher does actually say this, they are making a sequel to Star Wars, so that'd be quite interesting. I wonder where they'll go.
Shocking news from that one.
Yeah. In the booklet, you get loads of artwork as well, which is quite good. So,
The deleted scenes again for Empire Strikes Back are quite interesting. Originally, the Wampra ice beasts that can attack Luke Skywalker and he cuts the arm off one were originally meant to be a much larger part of that first section of the film, up to and including them actually invading Echo Base as the rebellion are trying to evacuate. They're actually like unfinished scenes of like a Wampa breaking through into a tunnel and Eve attacking a few rebel soldiers and Imperial troops later on. But the special effects are quite laughable, and obviously they dropped that from the film.
It's interesting to see.
Oh, it's very interesting to see. That's why I bring it up. It's quite interesting.
There's a bit where C-3PO kind of leads some snow troopers by pulling off the sort of warning sticker that they put.
Yeah, I actually noticed you can actually see that door and the warning sticker in one of the existing shots of the movie, so that's obviously like the setup
for it. Because they trap a Wampa behind his door and they put a sticker over it, basically saying, "I don't go in there," you know, kind of thing.
Yeah, and when he's running past, like, C-3PO just pulls the sticker off.
So the snow troopers go in and...
Just opens the door and there's this, like, massive pod just grabs him and he's like, "Whoa!"
Yeah, and then Darth Vader comes along and... There's no sort of dialogue.
Yeah, but it's kind of like you see one of the snowtroopers going, don't go in there kind of thing.
It's quite good. It'll be interesting to see. I mean, I can't picture them ever editing this back in the film. These deleted scenes.
Yeah, they're very, very early work. Obviously, they decided for pacing. And
yeah, these are just something that you watch as an extra on the bonus disc. They are incorporated in the film, thankfully. But you never know, George Lucas, he may someday do that just to make an extra buck.
Yeah.
But
and then again, like I said, somebody who would like pay out the money for this would be the sort of person who would watch the fully. I mean, I do it as well. I own the extended Uber editions of bloody Lord of the Rings. Are like 2 hours long each or more. I forget how long they are. They're ridiculously long.
Yeah, we're not watching those.
No, I know that. I'm using an example. I think if they did include a lot of these deleted scenes back into the film with like finished special effects, people like us would watch them and be like, that's cool.
Actually, interesting, I've literally just noticed this now. That's from...
Episode 3, yeah. And, well, I don't know why Boba Fett's writing it, because that was...
Is that what it is? I thought that was, like, the thing from the Christmas... the holiday special.
I actually assume that's Obi-Wan Kenobi's mount, because the thing from that is, like, a really long neck from the holiday special. Yeah,
it's kind of...
That looks like...
Reminiscent of it, though.
Yeah.
Might insert a clip of it here if I can find it.
As I say, Boba Fett, the bounty hunter character from Empire Strikes Back, was introduced previously in a holiday special in 1978. But copies are pretty hard to get hold of, even on YouTube. If you put these up, they'll probably get your video taken down. So I've decided to use some stills for this video, just to be safe. But this is the artistic concept of what he looks like in that. It's fairly similar to what you get in the booklet with the Blu-ray box set.
Yeah, other than that, not really much else to add to the Empire Strikes Back on Blu-ray. Like I said, the picture quality, as you would expect, is pretty much... can barely tell the difference from the Blu-ray because it wasn't filmed in high def. Like I always say in all my reviews of Blu-rays for old films, barely worth a difference, barely worth transferring on a Blu-ray other than the novelty factor.
Also, I don't think there were many huge sweeping changes made to this film in the 97 re-release.
I think
mainly improved special effects. They added quite a bit around Cloud City where you see some exteriors of it. And
yeah, that's still the same.
Where they'll be like going through a room and rather than just like a blank wall, you'll now have a window and actually shows you some of the city, which
yeah,
is
that was something
nice, really, nice little additions.
That was a 97 version. It came out of cinemas in 97 and also released on tape.
Which I actually remember going to see that at the cinema. Cause
yeah, it
was quite... Well, like we were saying, this came out in 1980, so we were actually not born yet when this was in cinemas originally. So.
Yeah, it was good to see, finally. Because I remember the old trailer, it kind of started off the special editions in 97. The old trailer showed, like, a really small sort of square screen, and it sort of said something along the lines of, you know, for a whole generation, people have only ever seen Star Wars like this. So for the first time you're going to get a chance to see it in cinemas.
I certainly think the sad thing about George Lucas's like cash grab that are episodes 1, 2 and 3, if he really wanted more money, all he needed to do was re-release the original trilogy in cinemas. People would have gone to see
it. Yeah, I would pay. They've re-released them, they started to re-release them in 3D back in 2012, starting from The Phantom Menace, and they were going to go from 1 to 6, but they just gave up, because I think not a lot of people went to see them, and they said it's because they want to focus on the new trilogy that they're doing, which will be episodes 7, 8 and 9, which
I'll
mention
in the
next review.
Purely on second-hand information here, but from other people who have seen it in 3D, other reviews... The general consensus is there's very little added actually in 3D. You'd think Star Wars would be awesome for 3D, but they weren't shot in 3D, they weren't intended to be 3D. The 3D conversions are rarely very good,
yeah.
And this certainly wasn't a good one.
And it was only Phantom Menace, like I say, that they ever released.
Well, do you really want to go and see Phantom Menace again in cinemas?
I was kind of up for it, but you...
I think I talked you out of it.
Yeah, you talked me to my sentences kind of thing, so I'm glad you did. I think we have to wrap this up anyway, because we're running out of time, but that's The Empire Strikes Back, unless there's anything else you want to quickly add.
No.
We're going to review Return of the Jedi next, that's going to be the last review of this. We've also got a couple of other bonus reviews that we're going to include. There's one of the Clone Wars cartoon series.
The original cartoon series, not the extended, kind of CGI one, the original animation.
And the expanded universe graphic novels and role-playing stuff that this guy, Mr. Core, or The Core...
Well, he's the expert in like the documentaries and
the films
and so forth. I'm a fan of those, yes, but I'm also into the extended universe. So
that's what we're going to be covering in the bonus videos as well. But they'll be up after we've reviewed Return of the Jedi. Anyway, thanks very much for watching. Check back
later. Return of the Jedi is next.
BrandXReviews.com. BrandXReviews.com. Thank you.